When discussing the skeletal system, probably the most clinically relevant area is fractures. Secondly, very closely associated is osteoporosis. Osteoporosis is one of the major causes for fractures, particularly in older individuals. So really, what is it? So let's look at this illustration here. And we're focused in on, this is a femur, and we're focused in on the spongy bone region. As you can see in typical bone or normal bone, you will still have spaces. That's normal in terms of spongy bone. In osteoporotic bone, that osteoclast activity, so remember osteoclasts are resorbing bone, that's going to stay fairly normal in osteoporotic individuals. What isn't normal is osteoblast activity. So you don't have the replacement of new bone keeping up with the resorption or breaking down of bone. So what you're going to be left with are these spongy bone regions where you have significantly larger areas and holes within the bone. So anytime that you don't have bone where you need to be, structurally that's going to play a big role and can lead to fractures. And that's really the number one symptom of osteoporosis. Now, typically, they're not the more extreme version, so you're not going to have these compound fractures generally. You'll have what's referred to as stress fractures more commonly. But with more stress fractures, that can lead to those more severe types. So either those comminuted fractures or the compound fractures that we've discussed in previous sections. With fracture, of course, you're going to have bone pain. So you're going to have those sensory neurons sending signals back to the central nervous system saying something's going wrong in this area. Even if it's not visible externally, you can generally feel pain in that region. One of the other more common symptoms is shrinkage of vertebrae. And with that, you get height loss, and you can get a fairly characteristic presentation of kyphosis. And colloquially, we refer to this as hunchback. So with time, you can get this kind of very distinct hunching of the back. And what's happening and what's actually allowing this to happen is you're going to have a multitude of stress fractures in the body of the vertebrae. And the body of vertebrae is composed of almost exclusively spongy bone. So you have these stress fractures that will eventually lead to the collapse of the body of the vertebrae. And if you have this occur on multiple vertebrae, that can lead to height loss in individuals with osteoporosis. Now, who does this occur to? Most individuals, if they live long enough, are going to have some level of osteoporosis. Generally, like I was just discussing, it'll be shown in terms of the vertebrae. You can have it in other areas of the body as well. And this typically happens in elderly individuals and even middle-aged individuals. Now, there's a higher incidence in women, not to say that males don't also have osteoporosis. Generally, it's more likely to show up in terms of women. So in terms of osteoporotic clinical practice, women are going to be the patients more often. And this can occur for numerous reasons. The two main reasons are women just do not have as large of a body build as males typically. So sexually dimorphic characteristics between women and men. Women have the smaller body build. Anytime that you have that smaller body build, that has implications in terms of how much spongy bone there is in that area. Secondly, estrogen production slows down in women as well, whereas testosterone in males typically can, you have normal secretion even later on in life, so that can play a role in terms of osteoporosis. Other risk factors, family history, like many other disorders. So if your mother or your grandmother had osteoporosis, you're typically more likely to have it. Ancestry can also play a role. So individuals of European or Asian ancestry typically have a higher incidence of osteoporosis. As we discussed previously, small body build can play a role. An inactive lifestyle. If you're not doing those weight-bearing exercises that are contracting those muscles and affecting the bone that it's attached to, that can really play a role in terms of not changing the bone, not having those osteoblasts secreting at a normal level.